people try to find out about you because you were not revealing things?
Yeah, people are making a lot more of it. Perhaps if we told them a lot of boring stuff, it would have made the initial impact a lot less interesting, but they probably would have left me alone. They're quite intent to find out quite a lot more, and there's an awful lot that they don't know at all, and with any luck, they never will.
But you see, did you realise when it started, this publicity, that you were in for some quite sort of heavy stuff, really? I mean, you see, you've been pushed into something which could come very, very big.
It doesn't bother me. I just take it as it comes. I don't think about how big it's going to be. I don't have any aspirations in that sense. It doesn't really bother me, you know, that the people are building it up in one way or another. If I see that it's getting too out of hand or they're not being realistic, then I can say things that I see certain things so clearly. But I tend not to think about what might happen. I'm only thinking about what is actually happening and what I'm actually doing, you know.
This is the first television interview we've ever done.
That's right, yeah.
First you've ever been asked, you told me, which is why you came on. Well, now then, can I tell you one thing? When I try to resist publicity, partly because in my job I really need to, in a funny sort of a way. So I only kind of half took you in on from your posters, and what I thought your poster was Woody Allen in a new film about a rock singer begging your pardon, if I should be. Are you a rock singer?
No, a pop singer, really.
Pop singer?
A pop singer, I would say. People get very worked up about art and everything, and you know, that's kind of why I'm a little bit skeptical about, as you said, the posh press we've had. It's because the concerns of all those papers, the New Statesman and the Guardian, they're so self-important, you know. Those things are really, they're really not a matter of life and death. I mean, architecture and art galleries, if they're all burnt down tomorrow, it might be a loss to the world, but it isn't going to stop anybody breathing, you know.
Yes, but you know, your songs on your LP, which I've listened a lot to, and grew to like more than I liked them to begin with, if I might say so. Can I tell you why?
Mm-hmm.
I couldn't understand the words, couldn't hear the words.
Yeah, that's deliberate.
Why?
Well, it's deliberate that it was mixed so that the words are not right out to the fore, so that people have to listen a bit harder if they are interested.
But you must be wanting to say something.
No, I'd print them on the sleeve if I wanted people to read them clearly. I like the idea of people can get the wrong impression. I used to have a whole other version of She Loves You that I'd worked out off the radio when I was a kid, and I worked it all off, and it was total nonsense. I can't remember it now, but I mean, there were all kinds of funny words in it, and people have come along with amazing theories about some of the songs on the album, particularly Lesson Zero, because it mentions a Mr. Oswald.
Mosley?
Yeah, it was, yeah. Well, I mean, Americans have come up with theories, not just kind of saying, is it about Lee Harvey Oswald, but actually saying it is, and they've worked it all out from the lyrics.
Well, it wasn't.
No, it wasn't. It's about Oswald Mosley, but... Yeah, you know, they worked it all out. They'd shown almost as well, probably more imagination in working that out than I did in writing the song in the first place.
Yeah, can I say this then? That even though perhaps the words weren't that clear, I did persevere and I did listen and I did like the sound of the music, and then I thought I was detecting, at least in your LP, a fantastic amount of rejection.
That's one aspect that people have kind of jumped on, probably because it's not very common in pop or in rock. It's probably more common in country music, which I'm kind of fond of, and that's maybe why it came out. It's only one aspect of the whole thing. It's like only about 5 songs on the album, and there are 12.
Mm.
There's little elements here and there. I think people have tended to make more of it because it's kind of different, rather than because it's really that it's not. I don't think the album is obsessive. The songs are each song is individually for what it is. I don't think about it as in terms of, I've just made this great artistic statement or anything. I just write one song and then the next, and each track is individual. They've kind of taken them as a weight of feeling and said, that's the way I feel about things, I feel rejected. And I'm not interested in becoming kind of a patron saint for people like that, you know, the kind of patron saint for losers.
But you must be reflecting, you're 23, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
You must be reflecting some people of your age in your thoughts.
Yeah, well, I don't think about that. I think the worst thing you can do, and it's quite a common thing in today, and has been a lot, I suppose, is anthem writers, people that write anthems, ready-made anthems.
Mm.
I think the only way that people can take things up is if it's honestly taken up by people, and that's fair enough. I think all the best songs, with possible exception of My Generation, which was an obvious kind of statement,
mm.
most songs that have been taken up by people in a big way, it's kind of done spontaneously. If you kind of write thinking, I'm now going to express the feelings of my entire generation, I'm now going to sum up the meaning of the human race in this song, I mean, that you don't stand a chance.
You wouldn't call yourself punk rock, would you?
No, I wouldn't at all, no.
Punk rock, when it began, seemed to deliberately draw attention to itself with safety pins in its nose, say, and I thought, to be honest, that the songs were sung in an insulting sort of a way. I took offence.
No, I don't really take offence at anything that much, particularly not not things like that. It's not so desperately insulting to me. I think some of it is a little weak. Some of the things, it's not that so much that the cause or the complaint isn't that strong, it's more a question of thrashing around in a kind of blind fury often doesn't make the point as clearly as a kind of quite quiet threat. So I think sometimes it's a little bit vain. But other things, I'd think, well, at least two of the Pistols singles are really excellent, you know. And I mean, there are other records, I'm not going to go on discussing other bands, you know, but virtues and demerits. And
do you think you're an angry songwriter?
It's, again, it's not a thing I like to kind of label myself. I'm an angry songwriter, then I've always got to be angry. I mean, this is...
But do you feel angry about
sometimes
things?
Yeah. I mean, I wouldn't write some of the songs if I wasn't angry, you know. But I don't take it up as a stance. I must only write in that frame of mind. I'm more interested in being a person than a celebrity. Yeah, that's why I tend to kind of talk about being a person more than kind of... I'm not interested in being a star. You know, I'm not interested in being a cardboard cutout kind of character, which you know, the Rod Stewarts of the world. They may be human beings in their own houses, but in terms of the general public, they've got a set, very, very one-dimensional image of those people.
How are you going to guard yourself against it if it suddenly takes you over? And it might very well.
Well, it's just a question of I keep expressing different opinions as the mood takes me. If I want to say something really that it cuts across everything I've said before because that's what I feel that day, then I'll do it. Mm. I won't necessarily adhere to what everybody else thinks is my image. Mm.